I'm Mashu Scanlon, the guy on the left.
This is Paul Cheon, also known as Haumph.
Join us on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific for Magic TV, where we answer the burning questions posed to us by you, the audience, like Chipotle or La Vic, or where do these guys get their hair done?
And also every single week, we're going to be having a special guest from Channel Fireball, like Louis Scott Vargas, Josh Arleton, Tom Martell, and many others.
With all that and Dark Steel Humphrey, we'll see you next Wednesday.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to a standard video. Today I'm playing Abzan. What I have in front of me is the exact deck list that Nicholas de Nicola used to make the top four of Grand Prix Santiago recently. I've been calling it Medium Abzan because it has the Courser of Krufix, which the presence of Courser usually is a good way to differentiate between the aggro Abzan and the midrange or control Abzans. However, this deck does not have Elspeth Sun's Champion, which is another hallmark card of the bigger Abzan decks, like Ari Lax's deck from Pro Tour Concept Tarkir. That said, I have Elspeth on the sideboard. I have some End Hostilities. So, on the whole, it's a pretty well-balanced deck, and I'm excited to try it out. It's streamlined in the main deck. The removal is just 4 Abzan Charms, 4 Heroes Downfall, and 1 Bile Blight with additional copies in the sideboard. No Utter Ends, no Silence of the Believers, no Murderous Cuts, nothing like that. But just basically the deck is built to maximize the chance of coming out smooth and just having the play you want to make for the first few turns of the game. 4 Wingmate Rocks, one of the best cards in the mirror and just really efficient, brutal card that a lot of decks are going to have a hard time dealing with. One thing that I'm a little bit worried about is the Whip of Erebos decks, the graveyard decks that have been popping up recently. I'll be curious to see how the match goes if I get paired up against one of them.